So it's a vision that this has materialized. I lived in New York for like 50 years, and I had a vision to come back here. This is my grandfather's land, and to build a retreat and cultural center for the people in Trinidad. I also look at it in terms of giving back to the community that I came from. Today we are hosting our emancipation program for the very first time in Trinidad, because we did it in New York for the past 18 years. Basically, we do it with kids at our summer program, but this year we seem to be having more adults.
Okay.
Originally, the first one we did was adults. So it is ironic that today we have adults.
And the bird and the branch and the branch and the tree and the tree and the seed and the seed and the hole and the hole in the ground and the green grass grew all around and around and the green grass grew all around.
I come to Palo Seco once a week, every Wednesday for the past 20 years since I'm here. And it's a joy to come to Palo Seco because I see nothing happens in Palo Seco. So we try to bring lots of activities in Palo Seco. We focus on the kids. We align with the primary school, a school that I have been to as a child, and it makes me feel very good that I can give back to that school in particular.
The same way Ina can identify, I came from Palo Seco and I can come back to Palo Seco. So we want the young people to be able, not only Palo Seco, we're looking at the entire communities around Trinidad and Tobago, the rural communities, who people don't hear about. And if you can hear about it from the voice of a young girl, and we identify the young girl specifically because we hear about the teenage pregnancy, we hear all about the wrong things that they do, but they can do good things, and therefore we need to identify the good and the beautiful in all the communities and with all of our young people.
The most important thing about establishing emancipation in a rural area or in the country district, because there's very little new information of the people in these communities who have made valuable contribution to the community, to the country, and even to the wider world. We have reached a stage now that the story must be told, but it must be told from the African perspective and nobody else. The other people could have the story, but you cannot tell my story, and that is what is wrong. So if we have the young people will have the story from the African perspective, they will not feel so out of place, because we are still having the experience of our children cannot use the natural African hair.
Yeah.
Right? And this is 2020, and I, growing up, had that experience, right? I have children, they don't have that experience. Our interest is not just for hair, it is an interest and a stability and sustainability for generations to come. And if they don't have the right tools, the right culture, the right tradition, the right information, then we spin it up in mud. Which is the important things for the traditional African women's organization, where we could sit down and have conversation with the elders, who would say to the younger woman the kind of experiences they have, right? And we, as a women's organization, we are not a women's organization for women. We are a traditional African women's organization. That is very important, because in the African tradition, it's about male and female, which is balance.
Right.
So we do have things with our men.
Right.
We have our men-only conversation, where our men could sit down and have a conversation. You understand? And that is the only how we could move forward as African people, when we put back balance.
Baby didn't answer, so she slapped the gun. Baby, what happened?
Hands
up.
Say, gun, baby, let go of my hand. Let go of my hand. I want to slap you and then whack her.
And then she put her. And there she was. And Anansi came up from behind me from her and she said, I'm what you are. You're ready to be these sky gods. You're ready to be these sky gods. You're ready to be these sky gods. And he spun him about round him. And he went up to the sky. And he went before Nyame. And he said, oh, Nyame, I have brought you the things that you demanded for your box of stories. Oh, save all the leopard of the terrible teeth. And borrow the hornets who sting like fire. And Mwatia, the fairy who no man has ever seen. And now can you give me lots of stories, please? So the sky world was a mess. Because for centuries so many people tried. And they could have never get. Look, this little man was an adid, they said, and he was a short man. And he found the sky, the thing the tiger demanded. He said, he called all his counselors. He said, come, everyone. From far and near, I decree and declare that you have to come here today because Kwaku Adansi has brought me the things that I have demanded for my box of stories. And from this day and henceforth, I decree and I declare that these stories will be called spider stories or Anansi stories, and they will belong to Kwaku Adansi. And handed, the stories were so valuable. Because remember, the principles and the values were more precious than gold. And they had real gold and diamonds and things, on the box. And Anansi took the box of stories and he bowed very low. And he said, thank you, great Nyame. I thank you for the box of stories. And when Anansi took the box of stories, he went back down to the earth. And when Kwaku Adansi reached back down to the earth, he opened the box of stories, and all the stories flew out of the box to every corner of the earth, including women of the soil face, and including in Palaseko, and that is how I see again the story.
What I would like for the other communities and the other ethnic group to know is that we have a story, we have a culture, we have a tradition. Right, and we need to respect everybody's culture, tradition, and way of life. Just as how I would respect your culture, we are saying at this time and this place, at this hour, respect our culture, our tradition, and our way of life. Stop imposing things on us because we already had a culture and a tradition that all the different groups around has bits and pieces of our culture. Mm-hmm. We just asking for respect.
Yeah. I always tell the kids at school though, don't ever forget where you come from. Don't ever forget where you come from. That's a defeat. But when you remember, as a matter of fact, we highlight the Sankofa bird. There's a history behind it. We are looking back, but we are continuing to go forward.
I want to pay tribute and to pay the greatness of our ancestors, past and gone. And I want to tell them that I thank them.
Ashe.